This first graph is about production possibilities, and this blue curve here, which is labeled PPF, stands for Production Possibility Frontier. So the idea is the firm can produce two goods, good one and good two, and the frontier represents the efficient combinations. That's the most of good two you can get for a given amount of good one. In the background, inputs are being held fixed here. You probably have seen this curve in Econ 102, and you may have seen it even in newspaper discussions where good one is normally talked about as guns and good two is talked about as butter, and the frontier represents the possibilities for the economy as a whole. Let's look at the spreadsheet a little bit. You have several controls down here, so let's scroll down a bit. The control B over here affects the curvature, and I will show that in a minute. The control over here selects the particular point on the PPF. So I'm going to vary those just describe what's happening since the controls are outside the video image. The B parameter controls the curvature as I raise it. And then lower it, it affects how curvy things are. And right about now, it's straight. There, it should be a perfectly straight line. When I lower it even more, it bends the other way. It actually starts to bend back. So, B controls the curve. Let me say a word about economies of scope here. If there are economies of scope, producing both goods together is more efficient than producing either one. That's when the, let's get this back to being big here, when it bowls like this, there are economies of scope. When it bowls inward, and I'm not going to push the buttons again, there are diseconomies of scope. You actually lose product as you produce both, so the efficient combinations are less than if you produce just one extreme or the other and average those. You also get to select a point on the curve, and the dashed line is the tangency point. The slope of this dashed line in absolute value gives what is called the rate of product transformation, or, if you will, the opportunity cost of good one. It measures how much good two you have to give up to get an additional unit of good one. That's an opportunity cost idea. There is a further control, if you scroll down, and let me show this, where you can turn on the revenue lines. So when we're looking at the technology, this is off. Now I'm going to turn this on and we'll go back to the picture. Now you see an ISO revenue line in purple through the point and a higher ISO revenue line. The goal is to get to the highest possible ISO revenue line, and you do this right now, if you will, the rate of product transformation is bigger than the relative price here, producing a little bit more of good one is making things worse. Producing less of good one is making things better. We're getting to a higher ISO revenue line, and the best point is something like that. And at the revenue maximizing point, the rate of product transformation equals the relative price.